almost every time I do one of these, I say, I can't believe I'm in the car with dot, dot, dot. But I genuinely cannot believe I'm in the car with Wayne Harves.
Good to be in the car. I'm lucky to be here for a start.
So what happened?
Oh, I had a heart attack. I actually thought I had indigestion, but I walked around the house for 40 minutes and finally hit the deck and rang the missus, and she came home and she put an aspirin in my mouth.
Yep.
And 3 minutes later I was feeling fine, and 4 days later I was having a 5-way bypass.
What was it like having a heart attack?
Oh, it was actually all right.
Was it all right?
Yeah, look, it's good.
So you'd recommend them?
As long as you live through the first one, yeah.
In terms of talent, fast, strong,
chunky, pleasantly plump.
Portly, I was going to say. Rubenesque. No. I was going to say, could kick it a mile. You could do everything, mate. So that, I just want that on the record, just for those who, some of our younger people watching this for the first time might not have seen you, mate. But before you started, did you win the Sun Kick?
Yeah, I was. That was in 75, I think it was. I think it was under 15s. And I just got my way through to the grand final. We had a kick out at Waverley.
Yeah.
And I think I may still hold the record. We'll have to find out. But out of 6 kicks, I got 2 within the witches' hats.
Right.
One went 76 and the other one went 73 and a half.
But these with...
But it was worth the $200, so that's what you got, $200.
Is that what you got?
Yeah, 200, yeah.
As a 15, 16-year-old, though, that was massive. Nice.
That was big, because I was, in those days, I was making $2 a week playing the under-19s. And $1 a week of that used to go out for the footy trip.
Wow. That's all you, by the way, officially on the record.
If I had a neck, I'd be probably 6'2". But I reckon 5'8¾".
5'8".
I'm a bit shorter now.
Playing weight?
What year?
at the start.
Whatever. Someone asked me the other day, when did I retire? I said 46 kilos ago. Playing weight when I went down under-19s would have been about 77. Finished up playing about 94, rippling muscle.
Bruce Dawe was in this car, didn't
he? I didn't hear it, but I did see the interview, yeah. Bruce gave me my first ever kick in 1977. That was my first night game at Waverley. And it was just an amazing night. Bruce was at centre-half back, I think he started. And I was playing on Kevin Bartlett in the back pocket. And Dooley said to me, if it pans out that the ball gets one out the middle by Richmond and I happen to get it, you just run. Well, it was as if he'd pre-seen what was going on, because Mark Lewis tapped to Waitman. Waitman's kicked to centre-half back, and Dooley's marked it. So what happened was Dooley's standing there with the ball under his arm, and he's stationary and he's doing nothing, and I'm thinking, this is amazing, and I'm thinking, shit, I'm supposed to run. So as Bruce turned around, he nodded his head, I took off, and he gave him my first kick.
So he waited for you, mate?
He waited for me, and then he said, next time I talk to you, listen. So I did. He was a genius. He's the best player I've ever seen.
You made the number 37 famous, but in your first game you wore number 54.
Wore 54, I did, yes. And Ken Sheldon was actually wearing 37 at the time. And Ken was asked by Sid Jackson if he'd like to wear number 5.
Wow.
So Kenny said, yeah, he'd love to. And 37 became available because there was only 54 lockers.
You're the last locker.
I was the last locker, so I thought I'd better move down a bit just in case others come in. So
Kenny Sheldon, I often remind you, must have been a great thrill to wear his old number for the rest of your career. He didn't do that,
well,
did he?
Well, to be honest, I forgot that he wore 37. It was him that had to remind me that he was the one that wore 37.
But I found it 17. Was it like playing seniors at 17?
Oh, it was pretty daunting. I was actually at the club I went there as a 14-year-old and started with the under-19s. So I was invited down to train at Essendon at 14 and told then by Ken Fletcher that I wasn't residentially zoned to Essendon. Yeah. He rang Carlton.
So Carlton, all these years, we have Ken Fletcher, Essendon great Ken Fletcher, to thank for you playing for Carlton.
Yeah, I guess so.
Honesty,
yeah.
That's nice. 79, you play all 24 games. Mm-hmm. That's all home and away, and then the final.
Yeah, I had a reasonable year that year, but it was we were never going to lose the grand final, as cocky as that sounds, because Jezza was coaching us. Jezza, what he did to us on the track during 79 was almost criminal. Should have been locked up for it. We had one session that started 5 o'clock and finished at 10 to 10, and that was after our first loss against Geelong. So that night consisted of 10 100s, 10 200s, 10 4s, 5 8s, 5 1500s, and then he decided he was going to put us through one-on-one contesting, which is the greatest drill ever invented.
Classic Jezza.
And after about 17 minutes of myself and Greg Towns fighting on the ground for the footy, I place the ball in front of him, I've looked up, and he's got it, and he's kicked it 60 metres away, and I've told him to go and F himself. So, I couldn't get up. And he actually scared us into winning games that year, and we were so match hard. As cocky as it sounds, I don't think anyone was going to beat us.
So how did you handle the transition to Parkin when Parkin came in 81, 82? Different types of coaches.
He changed the rules, yeah, David. He didn't like smokers, he didn't like drinkers. We went there to have a good time, and we didn't really agree with him all that much. And
he seemed like an odd choice, but in fact he was the perfect choice.
He was the perfect choice.
Right.
He was a university educated, smart, intelligent, and I think 99.9% of the players respected him, the time and the effort that he put in. And every time I hear him speak, I learn something different. And, yeah. You know, he certainly changed my life. Ribbon bloke. And here's where I had the operation, mate, up here.
We were going past the...
Royal Melbourne.
Royal Melbourne?
Yeah.
You were in there?
Fifth floor.
For how long?
About 7 days.
Half of everyone. Thank you. Thank you very much, Royal Melbourne.
We had to have a lot of pair of boots because there was a game, it must have been mid-80s, we played out at Moorabbin, and I reckon St Kilda watered the ground probably 3 days out from the game.
That wouldn't have surprised you, would it?
And it was a mud heap in the middle, and Kenny Sheldon and myself, I know Kenny lost two left boots, and I lost four left boots. So as I ran through the middle, I kicked and I stepped out of my boot and just couldn't find them.
They're gone.
And my dad, he never missed a game at Princess Park or any ground I played at. And Dad was known for his whistle, had this piercing whistle. And if I was standing in a back pocket and I was taking front posse against the forward pocket or the resting rover, and if he was to my left, Dad would whistle once.
Yeah.
And I'd know that he was to my left. Even at grand finals, 100,000 people, I'd hear the whistle. Or if the rover was two steps to my right, there'd be two whistles. My dad was my eyes and ears off the ground as a spectator, letting me know where, because I didn't like to play behind that much. So one whistle, my opponent was to the left, two whistles, he was standing to the right.
That is amazing. 79, of course, one of the things you're famous for is famously chasing down your own kick and hitting it back into the goal square. Kenny Sheldon kicks a goal.
It's the only thing I'm known for.
Well, you won a Norm Smith medal. Not because of that one single act. Was it for that one single act or not?
Look, I've been on record to say that I was not in the top 10 that day. And I think it was a sentimental vote. I've got it. Yes, I've got it. Will I give it back? No, I won't. The ball was knocked out to me. I've picked it up. Out of the corner of my eye, I saw Kenny Sheldon streaming down the middle of the ground. And Kenny had no one with him for 30 metres. Conditions weren't all that flash. And it was going to be easy. It was just going to be right foot over left shoulder, straight to Kenny. Hopefully 10, 15 metres in front. Kenny was going to collect. And as Kenny does, runs into a goal. And, it was a shit kick. They were all winners. They were all, hard, focused, do anything for you as you would do for them. And we were all there for the common goal. We weren't turning up on a yearly basis to run second, and I know it sounds a little bit smug and a little bit arrogant, but that's the type of players we were. And
mate, I'm almost contractually obliged to ask you on this about the 79. So, was the ball in or out?
That was in. As much as I, do nights and sportsman's nights and ask for the show of hand of Collingwood supporters, and yeah, it was out. They've actually sent the tape over to...
That's a good gag, by the way.
Well, you've got to... You just make them more upset and rile, because they don't deserve it.
No.
The video was sent to a university over in England, And there was apparently a goal many, many years ago in the soccer that it actually went in the goals and swerved out. And they did the video analysis and said that that soccer goal was a goal.
Yeah.
So they sent my tape over to England. And it states, they say that the ball was in, so.
Ball was in. I love it.
But if that didn't happen in my life, I'd, no one would want to talk to me.
It's the greatest respect. But, well, you know I would, because like I said before, people may have forgotten that you could do everything. But yeah, with the greatest respect, that was a shit kick.
That was a shit kick.
Oh, mate.
It was a stinker. I
can't believe I got to say that out loud.
Well, it was a, it was...
I said at the start that I can't believe that I'm in the car with Wayne Harms, and I still can't believe it. But, mate, thanks so much for doing this. I've enjoyed it. I hope you have.
Oh, and, very much so.
And, mate, on behalf of all Carlton supporters, just thanks once again. Thanks for being Wayne Harms.
I don't think I lied too much.